Christopher, when you take a look at Canada's housing, we're approaching the end of the year, just getting into those colder months. What do current market conditions look like?
Well, inventory is extremely tight again. Typically during this time of year, we do see a lot of less listings come out. We're getting into the holiday season, and most consumers don't want people coming through their homes, interrupting all the festivities. But it is cause for concern because right now, in talking to our peers and our associates in the different provinces across the country, a lot of them are telling us this is the lowest they've seen inventory almost in their entire career. So that is cause for concern, considering how much or how many inventory challenges we've had year after year in Canada.
Limited inventory having an effect on those average selling prices, which are up around 18% in Canada compared to this time last year. What is the answer when it comes to affordability, to the issue of supply?
Well, we need to find a solution that isn't what I've been calling Band-Aid. I mean, there's been government policy from time to time that is very well intentioned, but it's always directed at curbing the demand, and we really need to find a supply solution. Housing starts fell about 5% month over month, and that's actually the fifth straight month that we've had a decline in housing starts. I can totally appreciate, given that the world's supply chain is facing all kinds of constraints, that would have an effect on housing starts in Canada. But really, long term, we need to find a solution to be able to satisfy the demand that we are seeing in the marketplace. Otherwise, we are going to see continued rising prices. I do, however, think that 2022 is going to see a bit more calm than this year. But it really needs to be the focus of all three levels of government is to find a way to stimulate supply.
An interesting point that you make with respect to all three levels of government. We know that two of Canada's biggest cities, Toronto and Vancouver, will be seeing municipal elections next year. Is housing something that needs to be tackled, I guess, from the ground up with respect to the municipal level as opposed to that federal level?
Yes, it all starts at the municipalities. Each one has different rules and regulations for development. I mean, there was a time when you could build over, I think, 30 stories in the city of Toronto. And that has significantly changed over time. But that's because the municipalities allowed it to happen. So it starts at the municipal level, works its way up through the provinces. And then, of course, the federal government helps, facilitate funding in certain projects and things like that. So it starts at the municipal level, but there are all kinds of challenges that we really need to address. I've seen a big rise in consumers that are reluctant to sell because of the cost that comes associated with selling their home, specifically land transfer tax, specifically in the city of Toronto, where you have a double tax. I know that is a great source of revenue for the city of Toronto. However, the prices have risen so much so quickly in the past several years that it's becoming an even bigger deterrent than in years past for people that are wanting to move. And they would rather, for the most part, put that money back into renovating their homes as opposed to spending it on moving.
Let's get back to those home prices and what's fueling the market. Interest rates have been low, mortgage debt has been high. Talk to us about the factors fueling the market.
People have a lot of buying power right now, and they believe in the long-term health of the Canadian real estate market, which is a really good thing. But it does all trickle back to the supply challenges, and that's what's really putting the upward pressure on prices. And yes, people can afford more because the rates are so low. They're so low right now that even with gradual hikes, which are expected to commence in the middle of next year, that I don't see it having adverse effects on the market. So people have saved a lot more money during the pandemic. They are looking at home in a way that before was really based on wants, and now it's almost solely based on what their needs are. And if you've got a growing family, you need more space. If you've got pets, you probably want a yard. So there are many different factors that are causing people to look at their housing situations, and it is causing market activity that we haven't seen in a very, very long time.
You had mentioned at the start of this conversation that there needs to be a solution. Curious to get your thoughts on open bidding versus blind bidding. And is that something that you see as a solution to these surging home prices?
No, I don't see it as a solution to the surging home prices. There's lots of examples, Australia, New Zealand, that use open bidding as a way to sell homes, and prices have continued to go up there and at really high levels. But it is very apparent that consumers want more transparency in the offer process. I know it's a very, very hot topic across different levels of government, different real estate associations. And so I think we're going to see some movement on that next year, but I don't think it's going to be a solution for the rising prices.
Christopher, ultimately, when you take a look at 2022, and we often think of that a spring market, will we continue to see a constraint on the supply side?
I think with immigration now, you know, getting back to pre-pandemic levels and what is projected to go well beyond that, I mean, the goal is 1.2 new Canadians over the next 3 years. That's 400,000 people a year. Our peak of housing starts was about 335,000 in 2019. There's a shortfall there. So there's going to be a gap. Or is every single new Canadian going to buy a home the day they show up? No, it actually takes them some time before they make a decision on where they want to live and whether they want to rent or buy long-term. But it's still a deficit. And I'm sounding like a broken record here, but we've got to find a solution to address the shortage. Otherwise, we're going to continue to see upward pressure on prices.
Christopher, what solution would you like to see?
It's got to be a mix of municipalities finding. I would suggest if you're a municipality and you've got two land transfer tax, or even the provinces, consider capping it. As I mentioned before, that's been a huge deterrent for people to move. I think we've got to find a way to speed up the approval processes when it comes to approving new developments. And I also think that we have to make some very tough decisions when it comes to urban sprawl versus building vertical to accommodate the housing needs of the different provinces. So it's going to have to be a collective effort. It's going to have to take out of the box thinking. But it is becoming more and more of a crisis. And we can't keep doing more of the same, or we're going to get the same result. Thank you.